done differently?
Yeah, well, I think if you go back to the Rutgers game, we just I got too cute with the clock. You know, I mean, that's the reality of it. I did a very poor job managing the clock. And we checked the play there on first down, ended up taking us, or maybe it was second down, but ended up taking us a little bit more time. You know, we're sitting on two timeouts. Really, when you look at end of half management, regardless of the score, what you're trying to do is ensure two things. You want to ensure a score and the last possession. The last thing you want to do is give the ball back to the other team and let them have a chance to go score. So, you know, I think in the Rutgers game, probably should have used a timeout. Not probably, we should have used a timeout. We didn't manage that very well. That falls on my shoulders. That was really poor. And probably cost us an opportunity to score 6 points instead of three. And then you look at Saturday night, you know, I just really felt like at that point we didn't want to give the ball back to those guys to end the half. Certainly we hadn't played our best football for the majority of that half, or you know, whatever stoppage we were out of, I don't know, but certainly didn't feel like we were playing as well as we had opened the game. And you know, we'd given up a big play on defense. We had just come up with a big turnover after a bad series offensively. The last thing you want to do is give them the ball back at the end of the game. So we want to be pretty cautious. We had a third and four. We ended up converting that and felt like we had an opportunity to take a couple shots at the end zone. We weren't able to hit those. We put the field goal team on and kicked the field goal. But I think the Rutgers one was poor. And then last week, certainly you wish you could come away with 6 points, but that's just not going to be the reality at the end of every half.
Yeah.